There is outrage tonight at one of the country's most prominent universities. Penn State's Board of Trustees met today to vote on sanctions after a fraternity pledge died in an alleged hazing incident. Student's family says the changes don't go far enough. NBC's Gabe Gutierrez is in State College.
After the death of 19-year-old fraternity pledge Timothy Piazza.
Basically, the university's turning a blind eye to the fact that there's a bunch of minors getting served alcohol on their campus property.
Today, an acknowledgement from Penn State's president.
Today, we believe the self-governance model is broken.
The school's Board of Trustees did not vote to ban Greek life from campus, instead choosing other reforms, including taking more control of fraternity discipline, tightening restrictions on social events, and pushing back recruitment until later in the school year.
We are not going to tolerate this kind of hazing and alcohol.
But Piazza's family says that does not go far enough.
What I heard was a lot of aspirational language with absolutely not one concrete action.
Prosecutors say Piazza's blood alcohol level was 4 times the legal limit in February when he tumbled down a flight of stairs at the Beta Theta Pi house.
We have a friend who is unconscious.
It would be 12 hours before anyone called 911.
Nobody should consume that much alcohol. That's torture.
18 fraternity brothers face charges ranging from hazing to involuntary manslaughter.
Today, there was also more fallout from another scandal here at Penn State. Another case where university officials were accused of inaction.
Anything to say to the victims?
3 former administrators, including the former president, were sentenced to at least several months in jail for not telling police early enough about Coach Jerry Sandusky's sexual abuse of children. Gabe Gutierrez, NBC News, State College, Pennsylvania.